In this short session, I want to introduce you to one of the many tools that are available to assist farm business stakeholders in the business planning process. I want to emphasize that there are a lot of really good tools out there, all the way from outlines to templates to example plans, some of which are focused more generally, some focused on agricultural businesses. This particular tool has some interesting and, in my opinion, attractive features. AgPlan is an online tool that allows the stakeholder team to build a business plan over time with as much cooperation and collaboration as desired. It also allows the plan developers to ask for input from whatever outside stakeholders they want. Another attractive feature is that the tool is designed to interact with some financial management tools and resources to streamline the process a bit when developing the financial component of the business plan. To get started, simply visit the AgPlan website at AgPlan, that's A-G-P-L-A-N dot U-M-N dot E-D-U, AgPlan dot U-M-N dot E-D-U. Before beginning to work on an actual plan, you'll need to register the first time you log on to the site, which, as usual, involves setting up a password, etc. Once registered, you simply sign in using your email and the password you selected. Once signed in, you will be directed to either start a new business plan or work on one that has already been started, which will be listed according to the name that you selected. Obviously, what is correctly implied here is that you can be involved in formulating as many different agricultural business plans as you want, providing a lot of flexibility in using this web-based tool. For each plan on your list, right from the start, you can either click on the plan over there on the right where it says View Plan and begin working on whatever component you choose at that time, or you can choose to share that particular plan with others so that they can either work on it or provide you with review and suggestions. If you click on the Reviewers option, a list of people you've already given access to will come up. Here, notice that I've given Brent access to this particular plan, and I granted him the ability to not only look at and comment on the plan, but to go ahead and edit it himself if he so chooses. Since I am the owner of the plan, I have the option right here to remove Brent as a reviewer whenever I choose. Of course, I'm not going to do that because I want a lot of stakeholder and reviewer input as I develop my plan to make it the best plan that it can possibly be. To add reviewers, you simply type in their email address and then indicate whether you want them to only be able to view your plan and provide comments, or whether you want them to be a part of the plan writing team, and as such they can actually edit the plan. The comment only option might be appropriate if you were sending a draft of your plan to, say, a lender or your accountant or some other business advisor for feedback, but you didn't want to portray the expectation that they needed to actually help write the plan. Once you have typed in the reviewer's email address and indicated their role, a click of the button adds them to your planning team and they immediately get an email indicating such. Back to the main entry point for the tool. I'm going to view and start working on the only plan that happens to be in my list at the moment. I'm immediately taken to the plan with the general outline listed down the left side and what is currently a blank slate to begin working on the plan at the right. The user can choose to go anywhere they want in the outline to begin. In other words, the plan does not have to be developed in any sequential order. This first outline category, the cover page, does not, of course, have any subcomponents. Here one would simply develop an attractive cover page for their plan. Choosing other elements of the general outline will, on the other hand, bring up subcomponents that can be worked on. The blank slate is for typing or inserting relevant information for the various sections of the plan as it comes together. The buttons to the right allow several on-the-fly options, such as inserting a comment to remind yourself or others on the plan drafting team of needed information. Other button options can be used to navigate to other places within the plan, send drafts to a printer, or attach supplementary documents or files, like spreadsheets, for example, to your plan. At the bottom of the screen, there are several additional buttons that can be used in assisting to draft the plan. For example, the default button is the Tips button, which simply reveals some instructions or important points to keep in mind when drafting that particular section of the plan that is being worked on. Due to the space on the screen here, I'm only showing a small sample of the written tips that are associated with this section of the plan. However, when working in the tool, one can scroll down through a fairly extensive list of tips for many of the specific sections. I don't think it's necessary to take the time to highlight each and every section of the plan outline in the tool for you here today, since most of them function fairly similarly. However, I do want to point out in the financial section of the plan specifically, there are links to online tools that can be used to help assemble both the historical performance component of the plan as well as financial projections for the future. This online business planning tool was developed and is hosted by the Center for Farm Financial Management at the University of Minnesota, which has a long history and continues to be a leader in developing farm financial management tools. For example, under the financial projections subtopic, if one were to click on the resources tab at the bottom of the working screen, you would be directed to resources such as spreadsheets, along with short video clips regarding how to use those resources, along with many other useful resources to assist in the plan development. At any point, if you log out of or exit the AgPlan tool, your plan is saved in the cloud in cyberspace for you or for other stakeholders to go back and view and work on at any time. I know that this has been a very short overview of the AgPlan tool, but my hope is that I have given you enough information to try this tool out if you so desire.